His charms ensnared Hollywood actresses and a billionaire heiress. Today, it took a Brooklyn jury less than 5 hours to find Keith Raniere guilty on a host of charges, from sex trafficking to racketeering. The verdict comes after a decade-long ordeal for some women.
There's no words to describe my relief and the feeling of safety and freedom for myself and many others that have endured his abuse and stalking and terrorizing.
Raniere founded a self-help organization called NXIVM. Prosecutors called it a cult. The jury heard about a woman confined for almost 2 years as punishment for liking another man, and how Raniere had sex with an underage girl.
There were many tears in the courtroom. It was very difficult. Even at some points, the judge even intervened and stopped the defense lawyer from his cross-examination because he felt like it was pushing some of those witnesses over the edge.
Josh Block examined its inner workings for the CBC podcast, Uncover, Escaping NXIVM.
There's a lot of embarrassment, a lot of regret.
It told the story of Canadian actress Sarah Edmondson, one of many to get out. The court heard about a secret society within NXIVM called DOS. There, women were enslaved, even physically branded with Raniere's initials.
Women inside the group felt that if they did not comply with orders to have sex with Keith Raniere, that they would face devastating consequences. They would have nude photos and explicit videos released.
Among those who have pleaded guilty to helping Raniere, TV actress Allison Mack and Seagram's heiress Claire Bronfman. This former TV star's daughter was once part of NXIVM.
She, like all the other young women who have suffered at the hands of this monster, Keith Raniere, no one's unscathed, but she's not broken.
Raniere is facing up to life in prison and will be sentenced in September, but the ordeal may not be over. Raniere's defense plans to appeal. Stephen D'Souza, CBC News, New York.